Hi guys, Ben here from Vicon. Now, glue spreads around our transfers and the visibility, how to reduce that if you do get that glue spread and it is visible. Okay, just so that we know what it is and why it's there, all of our ultra color transfers are printed with a glue spread that is slightly bigger than the print itself to make sure that all those edges are stuck down onto the fabric. It's for washability, it's for longevity onto the garment to give you the best result. Now, in most cases, if you have a print that's got lots of color going onto a lighter fabric, you'll never notice it. If you've got a light print going onto a dark fabric, you'll never notice it. So around here where this colored circle is onto a black, you'd never notice. Where you will see that glue spread or becomes a little bit more noticeable to the eye is if you've got a dark print going onto a dark fabric, okay? And the reason for it is dark and dark, if there's anything in the middle of that, between those, such as the glue spread, which can look a little bit milky if it's not fully melted down, you'll notice that your eye is attracted to it. So I'm gonna show you a print like this. You wouldn't normally put onto black because it's got black edges and it's got black text, that sort of thing. I'm gonna show you how to make that look great even with that glue spread. Okay, so I've got a black garment here. I'm just gonna lay it down. Now I've made sure that my pressure is all even. I've got flat fabric, okay? I've got no high-rised areas. Cool. I'm gonna press this for 145 degrees, 10 seconds. We'll just let that kit pull. Countdown. Cool, done, pop that up. Okay, so I've done the full 10-second press. I'm now just gonna peel it. That's how it peels. A good, strong, confident, just sort of peel. Now, if I have a look at this, I can actually see very slightly that the glue spread around the really dark text is slightly more visible than I'd like it to be, okay? So what we recommend here, give it a second press and let that glue really melt down into the fabric and go transparent as it should be, okay? Couple of ways you can do this. Have another bit of fabric, you know, just single-sided, loose piece of fabric, okay, this here, and just place it down onto the gum. This is a little bit small, but if it was cut, just cut it up and then place it down, one piece, boom, give it another 5, 6, 7 seconds. That actually gives you a really nice natural texture as well, which I like. Otherwise, the transfer is quite sort of flat because the PET, the plastic, is flat as well. So that actually gives you a really nice finish of the transfer. Alternatively, you could put a bit of a parchment paper or like a baker's paper over the top, or Teflon. People have loose Teflon, okay, that they put over the top of the transfer and then just give it a second press. Teflon is a really good conductor of the heat, so it really pushes it through. Also, strangely enough, that shininess, the Teflon can make things a little bit shinier, makes the glue more transparent as well, okay, because that gloss, yeah, it makes it sort of push in and not catch the eye. Now, I've got Teflon on the top of this plate right here, so I'm not going to put a Teflon over the top. It acts exactly the same way. Now, I just put that down. You don't need to give it the full 10 seconds. Good 5 seconds is fine, okay? So I'll pop that up. Now, when I look at that, yes, definitely the edges there across the black text have definitely melted into the actual fabric a little bit more, and that edge is nowhere near as noticeable. So guys, if you've got transfers that you're pressing and you do notice that glue spread, it can be because it hasn't fully melted that glue on the glue edge and just needs another second press. Or it simply just wants to be pressed a little bit further into the actual garment. Using Teflon will make it a little bit glossier as well, so, and not as noticeable. Any other questions, check out the other videos, guys. Have a great day.